If you could put physical activity into a pill, it would be one of the most powerful medications in the world today. And physical activity doesn't need to be complicated. While you might be thinking you have to lift a bunch of weights, run 8 miles a day, and have endurance training as part of your exercise plan, while those things are beneficial and have their place, something as simple as a daily brisk walk can help you live a longer and healthier life. Walking should definitely not be underestimated for improving your health, and I'm here to actually share with you 5 benefits of walking that you might not have even heard of that was put together by Harvard Medical School to help motivate you to start walking more. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as being in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on the like button down below. And if you really like the content, then consider hitting that subscribe button too. Also, if you guys are on Instagram, you can follow me there too. Now, without wasting any more time, let's dive right in. The first benefit is that it counteracts the effects of weight-promoting genes. And there are about 32 established BMI predisposing genetic variants. And there were about 12,000 people in this study, which is a great sample size to determine how much these genes really contribute to body weight. The findings of the study showed us that those who walked briskly for about an hour a day, the effects of those genes were cut in half. Not just that, the equivalent of brisk walking 1 hour a day was associated with 0.06 reduction in the genetic effect on BMI, and each 2 hour a day increment in television watching was associated with 0.03 increase in genetic effect on BMI. This is because watching TV makes you more sedentary, and a sedentary lifestyle is actually one of the cornerstones of the Virchow's triad that explains why people develop thrombosis and form blood clots leading to heart attacks and strokes. Especially because the average American watches 4 to 6 hours of TV a day while being sedentary. The second benefit is walking helps tame a sweet tooth. And this was done at the University of Exeter and got published in the Journal of Appetite. They were able to find that a 15-minute walk can curb cravings for chocolate and even reduce the amount of chocolate you eat in stressful situations. Take a look at this. People often find it difficult to cut down on their daily treats, but this study shows that by taking a short walk, they are able to regulate their intake by half, which is awesome. The third benefit is it lowers the risk of developing dementia. And one of the largest studies that looked at this was done last year in JAMA Neurology, involving 78,000 participants from the UK, and found that a higher number of steps were associated with lower risk of all-cause dementia. The findings suggest that a dose of just under 10,000 steps per day may be optimally associated with a lower risk of dementia. Steps performed at higher intensity resulted in stronger associations. And this is largely because walking boosts the levels of proteins that strengthen the communication between our brain cells, and also because it supports cerebral blood flow to the brain. The fourth benefit is that it can ease your joint pain. Several studies have found that walking reduces arthritis-related pain, and that walking 5 to 6 miles a week can even prevent arthritis from forming in the first place. This is especially true with your knee joints that have both bone and cartilage. Cartilage doesn't have a blood supply that is always nourishing it, so it relies on joint fluid for nutrition. So by walking, this can be a way that you ensure the cartilage receives the nourishment it needs to stay healthy. My tip is that if you have joint pain, have been sedentary for a while, and you want to walk more, choose softer walking surfaces. Dirt and bark dust is actually softer on the joints than flooring made in malls and stores, for that matter, that's mostly made of concrete. Also, before I forget, wear the right shoes, please. Look for shoes with a wide toe box. What most people get wrong is that even a 1.5 inch higher heel can increase pressure on 2 common sites for knee osteoarthritis damage. So a low heel to toe drop shoe that is flexible is going to make a difference, and you can thank me later. And lastly, the fifth tip is it boosts your immune function, largely because regularly going for a walk or taking a bike ride can benefit your immune system by helping your immune cells to perform effectively, increasing blood flow, reducing stress and inflammation, and strengthening antibodies. The more consistently you move your body, the better prepared the immune system is to wipe out what makes you sick. Click the subscribe button if you found any value in this video. I'm more curious to hear from you. What do you like about walking? And until then, guys, I'll see you on the next one.